than any other chair. Hey, before we start, guys, can I ask a favor? I'd like to take a little video of anyone that cosplay of any show that I saw. And then at the end, I'd like to give them a round of applause. And this is where you guys come in if you don't mind. When I say action, can you just raise your hands and scream at the top of your lungs to give the people a good round of applause for the cosplay? Okay, that's a yes. I'm gonna say action because I'm a follower. Okay, action. You guys are awesome, thank you.
They're all sweet.
All right, well, hey, welcome to Sacramento, guys. You know, it's such an incredible phenomenon what Buffy has experienced. There's very few shows, you know, I think of like Firefly and the original Star Trek that just shows that just get better over time. The fandom just grows. It's an incredible phenomenon. And so, to get started off, there's a couple of questions, and then we'll go to some fan questions. Let me just ask you, you know, with it being 20 years, I like to ask each of you guys, how do you feel like you're different from when 20 years ago the first show started, the first episode to today? Like, how do you feel like you're different as an actor?
Oh, as an actor?
Yeah.
Boobs are lower.
If I'm honest. Most noticeable.
Probably
an actor that really does count.
Well, I mean, when I first started acting on the show, I didn't even know what a marker was. I didn't know what camera left was. I didn't even know if I could act. Really, I'm not joking. I just had a really good audition. So then I just pretended like I was a good actor, and that worked. And that's actually what I still do. I don't have that technique. I'm not a technique man. You know, I just pretend like I'm good at what I do.
I like Mindy. I think I learned how to act on Buffy for film. Because I came from stage where your face is like that big in stage and your eyes are invisible. But you're trying to let the audience know what you're thinking. And so it's all about expression. And you try to take that into a film stage and it looks really bad. I remember the light went on for me when I was doing a scene with Anthony Head, and who is arguably, I think, the best actor on the show. And I said, yeah. and
do you ever hear his American accent?
I don't know.
Sounds like John Wayne.
Hello. Hello.
What are you doing? I'm like, no, Tony, stop.
So when I was filming with Tony, what was going through my head was, oh man, would you wake up? I'm going to mop the floor with you. You're not doing anything. And then I saw the singing, and he was phenomenal. And I, at that moment, I said, I've got to relearn everything. I'm back to square one. And so I just started watching Tony Head, you know, go to the set and watch him work, even if I wasn't on that day, and just sit with the camera and watch what he was not doing.
My answer is also in his boobs.
There's 7-8 years of growth there on so many levels, and I think it's a great opportunity to learn drama and comedy and special effects and fighting, you know, for the camera, which is very different from stages, James said. So there's been a lot of growth as an actor. It's just now a matter of finding work to take all that practical knowledge to now.
Yeah. There's a microphone back of this. That's the aisle over here. Start lighting up if you'd like to ask a question.
Yeah, who's really brave? Like, not just a little brave, but like super heroic and brave. Yes!
So, I have two questions. I would like to ask each of you what your favorite, what was the most fun episode that you could remember on Buffy, and
The musical. It was actually better than some high tech. But yeah, it was just different. And then also probably Buffy vs. Dracula, because playing Redfield was a lot of fun for me. But yeah, the musical for me was just completely different than anything we had in the show. So I'm gonna go musical.
And then I agree with Nick, it's the musical. We had so much fun on the musical that the episode after that, which I think is one of our other really great shows, it's Blue Ross. That one, we were in the middle of that one going, this is boring.
where's the fun in this?
So that, and then also I really enjoyed going on to our Angels, on Angel, and kicking his butt. That was
awesome. Yeah, the musical was definitely the most fun to shoot. That was so out of the box for us. It was such a surprise. And it was just thrilling to watch everybody crush it. You know, that was just, I had no idea. I mean, I knew Tony sang, but I had no idea. So I just fell in love again with everybody on the show as an actor watching everybody. It was great.
I'm really glad I was not in this game. Both sides. Well, I took care of you.
No, I don't.
We like your karaoke.
No, you didn't.
You're laughing at me. My favorite episode was when Lionheart Part 1 and 2, when we were fighting and we kissed.
Yeah,
that was good. And that was super fun. Lover's Walk, Puppet Show was fun. But I think my favorite moment was graduation when I stayed my first band.
Quick second question.
Sorry, my second question is, does Joss still throw those Shakespeare parties?
No.
Aww.
Joss got kind of busy.
I know.
Maybe he throws them, but he doesn't invite us anymore.
Oh,
actually, we saw Joss when we did the EW photo shoot. And I thought that he was going to be a little changed since all his success in the world. I thought he'd be like, what do you think of him now? And he was the same dude as he always was, racked by self-doubt. And he was, just humble and loving.
He was actually better, I guess.
A little bit better?
Well, because it's like, before he knew that he should be where he is right now. And now he's at where he always thought that he should be. And I think he's very So, before, I think there was a bravado and an ego there because he wasn't where he wanted to be. Now he's exactly where he knew that he should be talent-wise. And he's just, it's really calling him now.
It's so important that it's that successful to be that down there.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
So, speaking of the 20th anniversary shoot, you guys have been on plenty of interviews over the years about Buffy. Being all together again, did anything sort of, new revelation? Was there anything that's
I just thought we're all really fun people, but it was hard to know that when we were filming because we're so tired. We're known as Buffy the Weekend Slayer. We worked up to 20 hours a day, so it was a level of fatigue that I've never felt since then. And then we did the photo shoot. We were like rested, like, oh, you're fun.
Yeah.
Continuing on from the AEW photo shoot, my question is, actually, can you share more experiences with that reunion photo shoot?
Yes, Dan Boranis didn't want me there.
100% true.
I remember hanging out with Seth, who he played Oz on the show, and he and I we only filmed together for a little while, but he was always one of the coolest people. He was a lot like his character, very chill, very funny, very laid back. And he and I just talked for a long time. It was just nice to talk to Seth again. Seth played a character. Oz was basically the way that Joss wishes he was in high school. Not at all. That was kind of my takeaway. I just got that email. Seth Green. It was really cool.
Thank you very much. Yes, go ahead.
Well, Charisma and James got to showcase their talents in Angel and in Buffy, and I was just wondering, which did you enjoy playing better? Which character did you like your arc in either one of those? Did you like Buffy's character or Angel's character?
I like Angel, and we barely worked together.
Yeah.
I liked Angel's arc for Cordelia. But I didn't like, well, obviously not Angel, because then, you know, he took over for Cordelia, so it would have been nice if we got to work together. That would have been fun, except for the one thing, when he bit me. That was fun. But that literally was kind of our only interfacing.
Yeah, I was only put into the cast of Buffy, the cast regular member, because I was replacing Cordelia. Well, I think I was supposed to, but I didn't work out, so to speak. For me, it was pretty much the same show. I mean, to tell you the truth, a lot of the same directors and editors, a lot of the same writers, I had already worked with Dave a lot, so it was pretty seamless for me. The only difference is that Angel filmed 12 hours a day, which after Buffy was like a midnight.
Hold on. Because the first three seasons was just as ugly.
Really?
Oh, God. Yeah, it was bad. It was very bad for all of us. I mean, people got into car accidents on the way home, and Jamie called up. No, it wasn't Jamie. It was, she's passed away, and I'm spacing on her name right now, but she would have to come to visit. She ran the unions, and we had to have our hours monitored, and, it's television. It's glamorous, kind of. But not when people are falling asleep and dying at the wheel, so. Debbie Downer here.
Happy holidays. Yeah.
And then I have one really quick question. Emma, you got to kiss Nicholas Brendan and Brandon Walsh. Yeah. And I also went up, so which one is better?
Brush your teeth with tuna fish.
Yes, I
do. Oh, God. How do I even answer that?
You don't have to.
It's the person that's fucking here.
But they didn't account for the fact that they were going to be spraying water on it during the whole scene, and it logged down with water and became like 10 times heavier, and suddenly the dragon is like the head puppeteer suddenly goes, oh my god, open up the dragon, and the puppeteers are, and they open
James,
the dragon and they fall.
Can you please do that again?
What?
Can you please do that again? Can you just say that?
It's like the dragon had a stroke.
Yeah, it's like the puppeteers, like they half faint, half fall out of the puppet, right? And then the director looks around like, what do we do now? Because you know, you're on the schedule for television, you have to get that scene, and the dragon is just. and so like for just like for 15 minutes we don't know what we're gonna do. And I finally said, well, just prop the dragon up on the rock, and then I'll sit in front of the rock and I will beat myself up with the arm of the dragon. And we'll get our shot. And the director's like, let's try. And that's in there. And it's horrible, but we actually got the scene filmed. But that was truly terrible.
I don't know. Copper. Yeah, that's where I'm at. Yeah. And they came up. Then they came up with the music. Dun dun. Dun dun. Dun 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 dun.
Back on, never mind.